Super Mario, Final Fantasy, Metal Gear Solid, Resident Evil, what do all these games have in common? Well, they've all been given a crap ton of sequels. But why? Because people continue to buy them. But hidden beneath the mainstream media franchises lie some of the games that I consider great. I enjoy them so much that I would love to play them again. This is the top 5 games that I think need a sequel. What's yellow, small, likes to kill people, and doesn't know his own gender? An alien, of course. This little gem was first created as a Flash game back in 2002 on Newgrounds.com. 2 years later, the creators decided to come together and make a console version. Completely built from the ground up, this new version of the game has your homicidal little friend running, jumping, shooting, and decapitating his way through 16 action-packed levels. When playing the game, you were on the edge of your seat because you knew in a true Contra fashion, if you get hit once, you're dead. It also happened to be the first 2D console game released in some time. It brings back memories of the good old days. You know, back when you only walked left and right. I don't know why, but for some reason, people are afraid to make 2D console games. Like, what's the deal? I know 3D is the new black and all, but you could throw us a bone every once in a while. Tom, if you're watching this now, halt all production on Castle Crashers and put your heart and soul into a sequel. Do it now. I command you! If you could go back in time to July 1987 and buy only one game, which would it be? Metroid or Kid Icarus? Yeah, probably Metroid, but that doesn't change the fact that Kid Icarus is one of the best games on the Nintendo. It was fun, addictive, fast-paced, and challenging. The basic story is that you're an angel named Pit, and you're chosen by the gods to save the world and do the blah 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 blah. Hey, it's 1987. Games back then were about one and one thing only, gameplay. Many people call this game a fusion between Zelda, Mario, and Metroid. Pit can jump like Mario, collect items like Link, and shoot enemies like Samus. He was awesome! And how many characters do you know that magically age 10 years in a matter of seconds? Oh yeah, well, Pit did it first. Everything about the game is great. So why, dare I ask, are there only two games in the series? Why didn't he take off like the rest of his Nintendo brother? It's like Mario, Link, Samus, and Pit all went to the amusement park, and after the day is over, they just left him there. Like, what the crap? Hello? You forgot someone? Whatever. All I know is he deserves a sequel. I mean, they already have a new model for him. There's no excuse not to make a new game. No excuse. Stop making crossovers and give me another Kid Icarus. Ever since the day The Simpsons was gracefully brought into the world by the power-hungry demon that is Matt Groening, they were completely showered with games of every genre on every console. All of them were mediocre at best. Except for one. You know what I'm talking about. That's right. Developed by Konami in 1991, The Simpsons Arcade took everything that was cool about beat-em-ups and made them even cooler. Excellent graphics, fun and addictive gameplay, four-player co-op. Man, this thing was great! I must have spent at least $200 on it. I was literally at my Chuck E. Cheese for 3 hours playing this every day. It was the most popular thing there. No one gave two craps about some guy in a mouse suit as long as they had their hands on this game. It should be noted that the game was also ported to the PC, but suffered from numerous glitches and a terrible frame rate. Not to mention you could play it on your computer using a program called MAME. Still, there's only one true way to play this game, and if you can somehow track it down, it's worth your quarters. Konami, wherever you are, please give me a sequel. I need one. I can't afford to pay $2,000 on eBay for the game, and my Chuck E. Cheese was turned into a Bed Bath & Beyond 4 years ago. Where am I supposed to get my Simpsons fix? Let's face it, the name has already been tainted by an onslaught of terrible games, but you can revive it, Konami. You have the power. Oh, I can hear the fanboys screaming now, but please give me a minute to explain. Sonic Adventure was a great game. Though many people fear that Sonic's jump to 3D would ruin him, once they got their dirty, sweaty little hands on the game, they soon realized he safely landed into the third dimension. 2 years later, Sega released Sonic Adventure 2, and boy, did it scream awesome. Everything about the game is cool. The graphics, the story, the introduction of a certain emo hedgehog, and of course, the gameplay. It took everything that was cool about Sonic Adventure and multiplied it by...
1 million.
It was that good. Until... Yeah. Okay, so you have three people following you at all times. I mean, what's the hurt in that? I mean, Tails followed Sonic since his introduction, so why can't Knuckles? At least the story looks interesting.
Ready to do this! We'll show that creep the real superpower of teamwork!
Teamwork? Seriously? This game has a frickin' moral? Jeez, we're not kids anymore. We don't need this crap. Give me some action. What? When did this happen? Since when do video game characters carry guns? I mean, at least not the ones who are rated E for everyone. But I should really look on the bright side. The game might not be so bad. Oh god. Where did you go wrong, Sega? At what part of your career did you say, you know what, let's take everything that makes Sonic good and not give it to him. Stop making crappy games and give me what I want. That's right, I want Sonic Adventure 3. Not some stupid moral-filled switch-em-ups and certainly not some gun-wielding emo freak. I want to run, jump, and spin dash my way through levels with one character only. This is why I am one of the few people that actually liked Sonic for the 360. It was the closest thing I got to a true sequel to Sonic Adventure. You only control one character, you run through a town to find your stage. That's it. That's what I wanted. Too bad it sucked donkey balls! Sega, please come to your senses and make a true sequel. I need it. Badly. Alright, first off, let me warn you that here's where my list becomes quite different from the rest.
Hey, Data, you're a kinda in the way, you know? Oh!
That's right. I would gladly give any one of my organs away just to play another Mega Man Legends. Released in 1997, this was Mega Man's first 3D outing. However, not everyone was as excited as I was. A lot of critics found the gameplay shallow, the story weak, and the camera terrible. But for reasons that'll take me too long to explain here, I enjoyed it. Kinda like those old Applejacks commercials. My favorite part of the game was the RPG elements incorporated to your Buster Gun. You could mix and match parts to create the ultimate weapon. Seriously, I enjoyed this game so much that if I had to list my top 5 favorite games of all time, this would definitely crack top 3. The story follows yet another incarnation of Mega Man. This time he calls himself a digger, and well, he digs. He's also a professional butt kicker. Oh, and a pimp. For real. No, really. You see, throughout the game, he gets not one, but two hot pixelated chicks going crazy for him. And that's not even the best part. At 2 points of the game, he gets to see each one of them completely naked. Yeah, you heard me. See? Nothing but a first-class pimp. Anyway, there's some big secret behind Mega Man's creation, but you have to play through the entire game to find out that he was originally created as a weapon but had his memory lost by a talking monkey.
I'm your peripheral memory storage device.
Yeah. Anyway, the game was given a sequel in 2000, and it was even better. It answered a few questions proposed in the first game, but also opened up a lot more. All was said and done when we were treated to this.
What are we going to do, Mega Man? If we can't get back to Terra, then I can't give Roy her mother back.
Don't worry, Yuna.
Why?
I know Roy. She'll come looking for us, no matter what happens.
Are you freaking kidding me? The series ends now of all time? What the crap? Well, it's true. It's been nearly 7 years since, and still no word on a third installment. There was some crappy spin-off released between the first two games, but that was, it was gay. Mega Man's creator has expressed a deep interest in creating a sequel, but has yet to do so. What is the holdup here? We're all waiting on you, old man. We want to know what happens. I mean, what the crap? You don't just end your franchise. You just don't end it like that on a cliffhanger. What is up with that? I need to calm down. Well, there you go. My top 5 games that need a sequel. What did you think? You agree or disagree? Have a different opinion than me? Express your thoughts in the comments. Because, you know, I read the comments and it's my life.